Not now, later.
Our tale today concerns the firstborn son of Charlemagne, and is entitled... But please, before we begin, let me assure you that what you are about to see is the true life story of Pippin. You see, there have been many misconceptions about Pippin. One that he was...
A hunchback!
One that he was... Or that he was... But please, cast all your previous misconceptions aside, and accept what we enact for you today. The life of Pippin begins. Pippin as a child showed tremendous thirst for knowledge. Immersed in these pursuits, the years went by quickly. Charlemagne sent Pippin to the University of Padua.
And the faculty of the university granted him special title, Scholar of the House.
Pippin replied to this offer in his own deeply moving words.
Could I ask more light, please? Well, thank you. Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge that you have given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books.
And Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life in commonplace, ordinary pursuits.
Terrific.
You see, I know there is something.
Oh, something fulfilling? Completely fulfilling?
Yeah, that's it. Something completely fulfilling.
Oh, fantastic.
And I'm going to find it. But I'm not exactly sure what I want to do or where I want to go. Everything has a season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats sit on the windowsill. first day I was home from Padua, my father sent me a horse. The second day, he sent me a falcon. The third day, I went hunting. And the fourth day, my father finally came himself.
Enter Charlemagne!
This part is to be portrayed by an actor of enormous power.
A giant in the battlefield. And in the bedroom.
Oh, thank you so very much.
You're welcome.
Well, good morning, son. Good morning, sir.
Well, welcome home, son. Well, hello.
That's what I want.
famine.
Denied. Next.
With fire, my cattle are dying, and my fields are barren.
Denied. Next.
But sire, that is unjust and tyrannical. I object.
Take this man away and hang him. Next.
Take Louis.
Yes, well, your brother Louis is an ideal soldier. He's strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
But I'm your oldest son. That means I might be king one day. Fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. I mean, after all, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves between Christianity to the entire world.
Well, that's what I'm talking about. You're dedicated to something. I just want to be dedicated to something, too. With all my heart and soul. And whatever it is, I want to do it as well as I possibly can. Otherwise, my life won't have any meaning at all.
Oh, you want your life to have meaning, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, it's very ambitious of you, Pippin.
Brother, stop all this bullet thinking with you! Well, where do you go, then?
Get yourself a decent helmet and come along.
I'm a soldier?
Soldiers appreciate, recall and recapitulate. find your attitude very disturbing.
I'm sorry, Father. Just all that talk about enfilade and defilade.
Now remember this, Pippin. The king across the valley is talking about enfilade and defilade too. That's the way it's done.
I'll know better next time, sir.
Well, I certainly hope so.
Just one other thing. I always like to spend the night before battle praying. And I ask that my two sons join me in prayer. Oh God, we who fight in your name and in the name of your son ask for victory in combat tomorrow. Father, is the Visigoth king praying for victory too?
Oh yes.
Both King Ulrich's own best prayers in the business. Louis, Pippin, it's time.
You're going to be very proud of me, Father.
I will try not to disgrace you, sir. Very well then, follow me.
absolutely essential to a victory. Celebration of my own son not joining in.
I'm sorry, Father, but I'm afraid you're gonna have to get used to victory celebrations without me. I thought there'd be more plumes.
Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be
Pippin! 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 Oh, Pippin, I got a leak.
Oh, how funny to hold you, you little boy.
Remember that, Pippin?
Poor grandma.
That's him. I can't stop Pippin. My God, you look terrible. You need some fresh air, some sun, and some good food. Some frolicking?
Grandma, sometimes you say really shocking things.
Now, Pippin, what's the matter? What have you been doing with yourself lately?
I went to war, Grandma.
No wonder you look so terrible. Men and their wars. Sometimes I think men raise flags when they can't get anything else up.
Grandma, you really do say shocking things.
I try my best. But really, Pippin, what's wrong?
I don't know, Grandma. I feel empty and vacant.
Empty and vacant? Now, Pippin, you listen to me. You're going to hear something very wise. Now, don't take life so seriously. Just take things as they come along. Don't do too much planning, and don't do too much thinking. How does that sound for wisdom so far?
Well, frankly, Grandma, it sounds pretty dull.
It'll sound better with music. Maestro?
He's cute.
When you were as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you were woefully wonderful.
Come on!
How do you feel now?
I feel empty and vacant. There's got to be something worthwhile I can do with my life.
Hey, you just started. There are still so many things that you can try.
Like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Good morning. Kensington Gold. Kingsley, 1000.
Hey, look
after this.
Hi there.
Oh, hello.
Peasants protesting rising taxes were slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne soldiers. The king warns that any further dissent will be treated in the same way.
I can't believe that. My father would never slaughter people just for protesting. It can't be true.
Now, would a newspaper print something that wasn't true?
Hi. Third massacre to bring new laws from crown. All political activities henceforth to be rigidly controlled.
My father can't just tell people what to think.
Why not? He's the king.
Well, I don't care. People have the right to speak out freely.
What have you done about that?
Something's got to be done about it.
You're absolutely right.
We're surrounded by injustice and tyranny.
And prejudice. Don't forget about prejudice.
Well, I'm finally beginning to see what my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land they couldn't care less about.
That's right.
I think it's time for a change.
Time for a change.
We've got to dedicate ourselves to a better world for all people.
Testing, testing, one, two.
Peace and justice must be restored to this great land.
Yeah!
The tyrant must be overthrown. Out the old order and create a better world.
Yeah.
Down with Charles, up with me!
Terrible. A son speaking against his own father that way. Why? I'd rather be drawn and quartered than to think I was in any way responsible for what happened next. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there.
Word had come to me that Pippin was holding secret meetings of a treasonous nature.
Revolution.
Pippin.
We pledge to stand by Pippin forever.
First, let me say that I admire the dedication and courage which has brought you here this evening.
Forever.
Second, let me be perfectly honest about some of the dangers which may lie ahead. If during this insurrection any one of us is caught, the king's vengeance will be swift and terrible. You will undoubtedly be tortured, broken on the wheel, cruelly maimed, even dismembered. But I'm sure that the prospect of these agonies will not stray from you. Join me in. They may appear frightened now, but once the deed is done, once action against the king is taken, they will flock to my side. Maybe.
Mama, if Pippin kills Papa...
You'll be next in line to the throne, darling.
But if Papa discovers Pippin's plot and executes him...
You'll be next in line to the throne, darling.
Mama, no matter what happens, I move up.
Yes, darling!
Trouble's already leave, and I'll fill a grave.
do, don't I?
I thought of Pippin. Your father loves you, Pippin.
Freedom and dignity for all people is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Yes, your name will be on his lips when he prays at Arles next month.
He prays at Arles next month?
Alone and unguarded.
Alone and unguarded. What date?
The 15th.
Time.
When the cock crows. Oh, Pippin, I beg you, bring this estrangement to an end.
I intend to.
May I tell your father this resolve?
No, no. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? How sweet. Your intentions make me very happy, Pippin.
You've been a great help to me, Estrada.
What sweeter words could a mother hear? I know that parable told in the holy book. I keep close on my shelf. Lord's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm really helping myself. And if we all turn on side of good land, then we can be all.
Chapel at Arles.
my son. You want something from me? A favor? Perhaps an advantage?
No.
Then what?
I'm here to be with you for one moment. To touch you, to look into your eyes.
And what do you see?
Two eyes, a little cloudy with age, sunset.
What else?
The death of thousands, the slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see that in my eyes?
Do you deny it?
Deny it? Well, I'm proud of it. I brought order on chaos. Slavery, blood, and death are part of that order. So be it.
Those are words from the past. Time has passed by, my son.
Your time has come, my son!
Yes, Father.
It's easy from where you stand to judge the things that I've done. But when I marched, the dust of the road was in my nose. When I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. I drank in the shores of the Volga and drowned two legions in the Vistula. My eagles, ospreys, and even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things are very clear. Birds float on the wind. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent and shaped an empire with it. Now, if you have no further business with me, go and leave me to my prayers.
What do you pray for, Father?
Strength. And may God give you the same.
Ghosts are waking. So many
a little tissue paper, I'll fix that right up. King Pippin, Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire, is prepared to hear petitions.
Come ahead. You'll all be dealt with fairly. My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I'm a very...
You may stand. You may all stand.
Thank you, sire. Sire, I'm a very poor man. I can't find any words. You have much, and I have nothing. Is that fair?
No, that's completely unfair. Treasurer! I hereby order you to distribute money to the poor.
King Pippin, the charitable!
About it. I hereby decree that from now on, all peasants will own the land that they cultivate.
King Pippin, let's go!
Sire, now that you've given the land to the peasants, we law nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we can no longer pay taxes.
Well, I hereby abolish taxes.
But sire, you realize, without taxes, you won't have money to support an army.
Well, that's all right. I don't need an army. That's it. No more money, no more taxes, no more army!
Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun is attacked in the east. He has destroyed 3 villages, raped hundreds of women, tortured and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Can he do that?
He has. But he will withdraw on one condition.
Well, that's very reasonable. Make any small concessions.
What's this condition? He demands your head on a pike staff.
Well, in that case, I guess you'll just have to go and destroy the infidel!
But sire, I have no more men to wage campaign. I have no more money to buy supplies. I have no army.
That's a very good point. Excuse me. Nobles! You remember that decree I made about land and taxes a while ago?
Yes, sire.
Well, that's all.
You mean you want me to pay taxes again and raise an army?
Yes, that's right.
But, sire, without land, I have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Well, that's a very good point. Hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? Why the hell should I have to work while everyone else gets handouts from the royal treasury?
You're absolutely right. I hereby revoke charity to the poor.
Up thine, sire!
Take that man away and hang him! No, stop! Wait! Would you just let me think a minute, please?
Job back. You want it? You got it.
Excuse me. Can I have my knife back?
Help yourself.
I'm sorry, Father.
Well, that's all right, son. Don't let it happen again.
Oh, damn it. Nothing ever turns out the way I thought it would. I'm getting old. Very old. I still haven't done anything with my life.
But you will. Well, you will, Pippin. You will.
You look frenzied. You
look for Azarin. Peaked as any owl, flushed and rushed and razzle-dazzled dry. Then your scalp, now I can see you're in a rut in disarray, and I'm not one to butt in the butt. Fact, I must say, if you take it easy, just a while, don't look blue, don't look back, you'll pull through in just a while, cause you're on the right track,
on the right track,
Peggy. Keep those hopes alive. Keep cool as custard.
Try hard,
stepping soft. There's no trick to staying sensible. Despite each cold and sap, cause each step's indispensable when you're on the right track.
On the right track.
Cornered him one day in a huge cathedral, and this is what he found out.
The church isn't saving souls, it's investing in real estate.
And then, when things get dank, feel their grip, go we stand. Tranquil, spirits high, pulses low.
Discarded rag would clean up oh so well.
Pierce that dedicated apathy. Now, I've always known that no man, no matter what his condition, can resist the charm of a small boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
Enter Theo, a small lovable boy, and his large lovable duck.
Pippin, Theo, it's my duck.
Well, how do you do?
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong, his name's Otto. You're not very smart.
Smart enough to know that a duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Obviously hopeless. I had picked him off the road and I could throw him back out again. Out he goes. I'm gonna give him another chance. Pip,
Pippin, you've been lying in this bed for 7 days. What is the matter with you?
Well, it's nothing you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance.
All right. You see, I have an overwhelming need to be completely fulfilled. It's never ever happened to me. So I'm in abject despair.
And that's it?
Yes, that's it.
You may think what I did next was scheming and devious. Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day he was struck down by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt that my life too was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days. But on the 6th day I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to run, and a boy to raise. Would you look at that? I think he's really moved. Pippin, this is such a large estate. All alone here, and I can't possibly do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right, all right. Just for a little while, though.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working, and slowly he became part everything, part of our everyday lives.
How often do we do this?
Every day. Every day?
Uh-huh. Every day, that's exciting. Say something?
No.
I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a small boy, a large estate, and no one to sit at the head of the table.
At first, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm for the work, but as time went on, he showed absolutely no enthusiasm at all.
Keep up going, boys. What are you looking at?
Nothing. Nothing. Oh, Pippin, there is something. The roof on the chicken house has sprung a leak. If you could get to it tomorrow.
Wait a minute.
Or the day after tomorrow.
The roof on the chicken house? I used to be emperor of the Holy Roman Empire, you know. So I screwed it up. Still.
Patch the roof and pitch in the hay. It's not my idea of a perfect day when you're extraordinary. You need to do extraordinary things. I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you need to do extraordinary things. That's the reason I'll never be the kind of man who dwells on how long it's got into the tapestry and why the dungeon smells. Oh, it's hard to feel special, it's hard to feel big, eating a turtle and walking a pig. It's so sedentary. Someone who is very extraordinary like me. If the moat won't stop leaking and the goat won't stop shrieking and the griffin keeps losing its hair and the west wing is rotting and our best wine is floating, well, I'm terribly sorry.
got sick.
Pippin, Otto is sick!
That's too bad for you. I'm sorry.
Pippin, it's the first time he's come to you for help.
Could you live in us, please?
Please, Pippin.
I don't know anything about Doc's.
Pippin, try.
All right. Let me have a look at him.
Now say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck. Nothing I can do for him.
Wait a minute, Theo.
Yes, there is. I'm over here. Kneel down right here over next to me.
It was beautiful. Like a painting, man and boy at prayer.
God, I know this is going to sound ridiculous, but this boy loves his duck.
They prayed all day, and then just after sunset, the duck died.
I'm sorry, Theo. We can go to the pond and get another duck. Why'd the damn duck have to die?
And then an interesting thing happened. Theo plunged himself into monumental despair, while Pippin, on the other hand, the prince of despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirit.
Theo, hey, Theo. We're going out to thrash some grain right now, and we need another good man. You want to give us a helping hand? Another time, maybe.
But Pippin showed remarkable persistence. When one thing failed, he tried another.
Hey, Theo, look what I got for this time. Got a skateboard for you. You can be the fastest little boy in the world.
Well, most men would have given up. But Pippin, with amazing perseverance, tried yet another way.
Hey, Theo, guess what I got for you this time? Okay, I'm gonna bring it right down, so don't turn around. Okay, when I count to three, you can look. One, two, three, look.
That's not a duck, dummy!
Did I say it was a duck? Yeah, go on, you were a flop.
It's been a long time.
No, I just forgot. You know, I think...
Yes?
It'll be better.
Next time?
Next time.
A little bit of that.
A whole lot of that.
But the season changed, as it always does. And the days were filled with those everyday things. Seeds to be sown, fences to be mended, and of course, finally, a love song.
trading old beliefs and humming old songs
and lowering old defenses,
singing a love song. La di da di la 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 la. Love song. La 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 la. Little jokes and silly bets.
Thank you.
finally realized what we knew from the beginning.
What's that?
That your student perfection and fulfillment was doomed.
Yes.
Nothing ever turns out the way you think it's going to.
Everything's flawed in one way or another.
Isn't that right?
Nothing has been completely fulfilling, now has it, Pippin?
No. I guess there's nothing.
Wait a minute. There is something.
There is? What?
The only completely perfect act in our repertoire, the finale! Yes. When he does it, yes, it's a trick. But when you do it, it'll be for real.
When I do it? You mean you want me to get into that box and set myself on fire?
You step into the flame, become part of that flame.
Be engulfed by that flame.
For one moment, shine with unequaled brilliance.
Become the perfect synthesis of life and death.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the great Pippin in our grand finale never before seen on a public stage.
Look, this finale is going to be so spectacular, why don't one of you do it?
Look, we're just ordinary, everyday people. Just your average men and women who keep this old world spinning. Hell, then nothing. But you, you're an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams.
You deserve an extraordinary climax.
An unparalleled finale.
It's everything you've been looking for.
A dream, complete and ultimate. Perfection, like the sun blazing in the sky.
The sun. The sun, at its zenith.
Think about your life, and
these are tame and nice to say.
Think about being a king, and what. Pippin, get back in.
Get out of my way! Leave me alone!
This is your finale, Pippin. Leave me alone.
I'm not a river or a giant bird that soars to the sea. And if I'm never tied to anything, I'll never be free.
What the hell are you two doing here? Pippin, where do you think you're going? Stop all this nonsense and get back to the finale. The finale, Pippin!
Tower!
Keyboard.
You try singing without music, sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much.
Pippin, do you feel that you've compromised?
No.
And do you feel like a coward?
No.
And how do you feel?
Trapped. But happy. Which isn't too bad for the end of musical comedy.
Thank you. Wait. golf game praying for victory too?
Oh yes.
You're going to be very proud of me, Father.
Gracious, sir. Very well, then.
A Free Minute from Pippin, Broadway's musical comedy sensation, directed by Bob Fosse. Other 119 minutes of Pippin live at the Imperial Theater without commercial interruption.
Strength, and may God give you the same.
Life, Pippin.